guys, I've got another video for you. This video, I'm going to be adding the spacer lift to raise this Land Rover up. It's not a big lift. It's I think they say it's an inch lift through Atlantic British. I think it is just a little bit more than an inch and a half or something. The tires actually raise the vehicle up at least an inch, maybe an inch and a half. You can actually tell how much higher you're sitting, so it should end up, you know, with the tires and this block spacers to be about a good 2-inch lift. So I mean, that's good enough for me just to ride around town. So I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching. The axle jacked up, and got all the bolts loose. Just gotta do one more and take the wheel off. Guys, the shock is bolts out. It's been jacked up on the axle, and then I jacked the whole frame up, the whole body up to take pressure off the shock so I could loosen that bolt and take it loose. And I'm about to try to drop the axle some to see if it'll fall down far enough for me to get the spring out. Still pretty tight. Alright guys, I went ahead and took the brake caliper off because I felt like it was putting stress on the cable I got heard, so I'm going to try to raise it up a little more. Okay guys, got it out with a pry bar finally. I took that off, was able to push it down a little bit more. Got the spring out. And I've started compressing it out here on the ground. It's easier out here. So now I gotta try to take the bolts out of here and put the spacer in there. Alright, sorry I didn't record that one, but I unscrewed that one, put the block on, put the piece back on, and put the new screws through that are the longer, just the size of the block. I had to go to a parts store to get those. It's definitely compressed enough. Let's see if I can get this uncompressed. It's easier to do that. All right. Tricky. Just need something to hold it in place. A bit of work. Got it. Need to jack the rear end back up so I can put the shock on. Thank you. right there. Alright guys, it's back together with the lift on this one side. Now I gotta put the brake caliper back on, but I'm gonna try to clean these pads just a little bit. They look pretty nasty. Okay guys, I threw this back on, just had to do a couple wipes. See if I can put this thing back in its spot. Only in one of those, so now it's in both. It's all back together for this side, and we'll do the other. So guys, I've got it jacked up like I did on the back here, and I'm ready on the side. I haven't really jacked it up yet. Got the wheel off. Took this air cleaner off so I can get to the top of the shock. I'm gonna take the shock bolt out. And then I'm going to take the tower out, and maybe I can use the lawn extension and get to here. I'm going to get these two bolts out. I'm not sure. I may have to go into the side. I really didn't want to. Okay guys, had to use two crescent wrenches. Started the big one first and went to the smaller one once it started loosening up. Now I can get this out. It's so tight. Not sure if I can still get it out for this thingy bob right here. I really don't want to move it. Let's see. Okay guys, I just took all the shock tower nuts off. There's four of them, two on this side and then two in the engine compartment. Deep weld 13 is what it is. I used a super long extension here for inside the motor. Right there. I've got a persuader. I got to move in. No, no, no. Just try to open the end, see if we can get the other part. There it goes.
bore on there.
Now I can't get the wrench out. Well, I'm going to try to drop it and see what happens. See if I can pull this out. There it is, fellas. Get it out. Whew. Got this dropped a pretty good bit. I'm gonna start raising the side of the car up now. See how loose I can get the spring. I may clean my hands. But I wouldn't have to do that. I had to bottle jack it here off this axle. Try to get it small enough. I mean, big enough opening here. Still not quite. See if I can pry it in. Ah, success! That was tough. The rear is definitely easier. down anyway. See if I can start letting the pressure off. A bit more loosening. Got it. Alright, I put the bolt in but I haven't tightened it yet, and I'm going to put these little nuts back on here that I took off. If I can figure out what I do with the wrench. Should be one more somewhere. One. Okay, I'm gonna do the shock collar. It's moved around. It should be easier to get off next time if I start putting shocks in or something. For this side, just gonna put the wheel back on, drop the jacks. Okay guys, that wraps up another one. Looks like I got about 2 inches between the Atlantic British lift and the bigger tire size, which is about what I was wanting. So hope you liked the video. If you do, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.